Love them or hate them, prequels usually serve the purpose of either filling in character backstory or expanding the film's universe, or both. Sometimes they end up destroying the mystique of a film by over-explaining the origins. I'm looking at you, Star Wars: A Solo Story. And some films just build up even more intrigue and make the universe seem much larger and more captivating than before. Regardless of your stance on prequels, 2024 and beyond seem to be serving up a few that will fill a space in some major film franchises. Before we begin, please like, share, and subscribe to our channel. Every new sub helps us achieve our goal and keeps us motivated to create new content. With that being said, I'm your host, Jamie, and here are 8 upcoming prequels in major franchises. Number 1. Alien: Romulus. Ridley Scott has returned to work with Fede Alvarez while he directs this upcoming film. Set to be released on August 16th, there's still not a lot we can tell you. The studios are doing a fantastic job at keeping secrets. All we know is we're going to be following a group of young colonists who are out scavenging anything they can find when they come in contact with a terrifying alien. The timeline is said to be between the first 2 installments, which would help tie things together better. Fortunately, it will have a theatrical release instead of straight to streaming like they initially intended. This deserves to be seen on the big screen, and you should make sure to check this out when it releases. Number 2. A Quiet Place, Day 1. We are a tad late on this one, as it just released on June 28th. But we have to talk about it. We all remember A Quiet Place, where you have to stay silent to stay alive. But how did this all come to be? We now have answers, as meteors came crashing into Manhattan, spawning our terrifying aliens as they can track any kind of sound. In this film, Sam is a terminally ill cancer patient when she goes on an outing with the facility. That's when the meteors start dropping, and she wakes up in a theater and being told to stay put and be quiet. She encounters Eric, who is a law student, and very nice to her. Even goes and gets her pain meds so she can be comfortable. You really have to check this out. It is receiving a lot of positive reviews, so check it out in theaters before it's too late. But if you can't, it will be released to digital download on July 30th. Number 3. Mufasa, The Lion King. I've always wondered the backstory on Mufasa. He's such a gentle lion, willing to teach as long as you pay attention, but also has that mean side when you mess with his kid. I want to know how he came to be the greatest king the Pride Lands ever saw. The story's gonna start off with Rafiki telling Simba and Nala's daughter Kiara about Mufasa, and Timon and Pumbaa are there to help with some colorful commentary. I am so excited to see this. Seth Rogen, Donald Glover, and Beyoncé are all set to reprise their roles, with the addition of Aaron Pierre, Mads Mikkelsen, and her feature film debut, Blue Carter. Take some time to relax this holiday season and catch this in theaters on December 20th. Number 4. Lord of the Rings: War of the Rohirrim. The Lord of the Rings is a long journey that takes over 9 hours to completely watch, and we aren't including the Hobbit part of this tale. With this new film, it's going to take place about 183 years before the Fellowship was formed, giving a chance to see how Helm Hammerhand and his family defeated the villains, and see why Helm's Deep has been named that way. I can't wait to see what they do with this film, as it's going to be an anime. Part of me is a little leery, but the other part? I'm excited. It could really go 2 ways, and I'm hoping it turns out to be the best installment in the franchise, since they'll be able to give more character arcs, explaining things a little better and whatnot. Either way, make sure to head to theaters to check this out on December 13th.
Looking for some new duds to dazzle your friends and family with? Support Fat Ninja Studios by heading over to fatninja.shop and checking out our very own merch store. We've got everything from shirts, hoodies, hats, shoes, and more. Again, check out fatninja.shop. Every dollar spent goes to our big fund jar and helps us produce more quality content and short films. Thanks again.
Number 5, Wicked. There is a lot of history going into this film, as the characters are from L. Frank Baum's novel, The Wonderful Wizard of Oz. That also takes into account the movie we're all used to. But this one is going to be taking place before Dorothy ever arrived in Oz. We'll see how Elphaba becomes the Wicked Witch of the West, why her and Glinda don't get along later on, and see how it all comes together. This film is a musical, which turned me away at first, but the creative genius of Winnie Halsman has me intrigued. I'm really looking forward to seeing this on November 22nd this year, with a part 2 to follow up on November 26th, 2025. Number 6, Ballerina. Don't let this title fool you. It's actually a John Wick film, the 5th one to be exact. And yes, Keanu Reeves does appear in this film. The premise is simple. A ballerina seeks revenge on those who murdered her family. And the timeline puts the story between the first and second installments. Ana de Armas will be our protagonist, with supporting actors such as Angelica Houston and Lance Reddick in his final on-screen role. I have to say, if they keep that same energy throughout this film that they did with the rest of the franchise, it'll be worth it. This film was supposed to be released on June 7th this year, but producer Chad Stahelski wanted more action, so it took a little more time. Now it's scheduled to be released on June 6th, 2025. Number 7, Star Wars Rogue Squadron. Star Wars fans, be ready for some new starfighters as they venture to the edges of the universe. Lucas's universe, that is. Originally set to be released in December of 2023, there have been a lot of holdups due to Patty Jenkins' schedule, writing new scripts, and many cancellations. It's on though, and I for one am excited to see what this new generation brings and what trials they'll face. Make sure to keep an eye out for this, and we'll let you know what we find out. When we find out. Number 8, Star Trek Origins. We just learned earlier this year that an origin story was coming out for this franchise, and it's gonna be good. There's not a whole lot out about it yet, but it could follow the storyline of how the Starfleet came to be, what happened after they first met aliens, or even be a reboot to the entire franchise. Paramount announced earlier that filming would start sometime this year, so we're hoping for a 2025 release. But that could be pushed further away. I'm very curious about this one, and we'll let you know all the details when we get the information. Thanks for checking out the video. Did we leave any films off the list? Let us know in the comments. If you enjoyed this video, please like, share, and subscribe to our channel. Don't forget to tap that bell icon to stay up to date with our latest releases. You can reach out to us on Twitter or X at StudiosFat. Or chat with us on Discord, linked below. Make sure to check out our very own merch store located at fatninja.shop. All proceeds go towards our next film project, so we'd greatly appreciate it. I've been your host, Jamie. Thanks again. See you in the next one.